الله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ثم أما بعد عباد الله فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولده ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئا إن وعد الله حق فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور أيها المؤمنون ننظر اليوم بإذن الله تعالى في قصة ذكرها الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم قصة لم تذكر بتفاصيل كثيرة وإنما سردها الله سبحانه وتعالى بعبارات مقتضبة مختصرة مركزة لتكون هداية للبشرية إلى أن يرث الله الأرض ومن عليها هذه القصة أيها الأحبة إنما هي قصة مجرم من المجرمين وطاغوت من الطواغيت وظالم من الظلمة قصة رجل بغى على قومه وتكبر واستكبر فذكر الله ما حدث من قومه عندما رأوا طغيانه وعدوانه وما كان إليه مصيره ومآله إننا اليوم ونحن نتذاكر هذه القصة لنرى عظمة القرآن الكريم لنرى سر بلاغته الإلهية لنرى أيضا في هذه الأيام أن ذلك الرجل لم يعد رجلا بل أصبح نظاما عالميا يتحكم في أرزاق العباد وأقواتهم وحرياتهم بل إنه لا يتحكم في ضمائرهم وأرواحهم وقلوبهم حتى صار الناس عبيدا له يفرحون بالظلم ويسيرون طواعية إلى حيث يفر الناس من الهلاك بل إنهم لا يتسابقون إلى مهالكهم ومصارعهم هذا النظام العجيب النظام القاروني الطاغوتي الذي طغى وأفسد وظلم حتى إن الناس صاروا يهربون من الحرية والكرامة إلى الذل والمهانة تحت سيادة ذلكم القارون الجديد أيها المؤمنون إننا ونحن ننظر في هذه الكلمات في كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى لنرى روعة كلام الله ودقة ذلك الخالق العظيم الذي أرشد عباده إلى ما يصلح لهم ولا شيء يصلح لهم إلا ما يراه الله سبحانه وتعالى صالحا نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعل هذا القرآن العظيم لنا قائدا ومرشدا وأن يجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. Today inshallah we are going to look at a story that Allah mentioned in the Quran. It was mentioned just by name in other places, but in a bit more details in Surah Al-Qasas. It's a story of a tyrant, a story of an oppressor. That's different to other oppressors. It's different to Fir'aun and it's different to the people of Ad and Thamud and others. This man is mentioned in Surah Al-Qasas after the story of Fir'aun to show us the tyranny of power and then the tyranny of wealth. To show us that actually tyranny has nothing to do with the background and has nothing to do with the language. The tyranny can take over almost everyone. And this story that Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Qasas is an example to follow. It's an example for us to study in order to avoid سبيل المجرمين, the path of the criminals. Because yes, Allah mentioned something that a bit extreme about that person, but actually there are minor or smaller tyrants in many of us. And actually also in this time, we see this man, Qarun. In this time, he's not actually a man anymore. This man has become a global system. This man has become a system that oppresses everyone. This man has become a system that does not only oppress the bodies of the people, but actually enslaves their hearts, enslaves their freedom and faith. We see something amazing now. The people go to slavery of this Qarun of today willingly. Actually, they compete to be good slaves of Qarun today. Let's go quickly to the verses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, and we try to study them in this brief time. Allah says in Surah Al-Qasas, Inna Qarun kana min qawmi Musa fabagha alayhim. Wa ataynahu min al-kunuzi ma inna mafatihahu latanu'u bil'usbati ulil quwwa. Indeed, Qarun was one of the people of Musa. He was not Egyptian. He was from the children of Israel that Allah chose to be the best people of that time. That Allah chose to be the people of the message, the followers of his messenger Musa alayhi salam. Qarun was one of them. Some narrations say he was the cousin of Musa. Qarun, Allah said, كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى فَبَغَى عَلَيْهِمْ. He transgressed. He oppressed them. And Allah doesn't tell us the details of this transgression. How did he oppress them? Was it by consuming their properties? Many wealthy people do that. Because of the power their money gives them, they start taking other people's properties because no one can stop them. Did he oppress them by not paying them their wages? Possibly. Did he oppress them by not giving them their rights in his wealth? What rights are we talking about? The right that Allah mentioned, وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌ مَعْلُومٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. Those who are wealthy have right in their wealth to the poor and needy. It's a right. It's not because of their generosity or kindness. It is the right of the poor and needy. Allah says in Surah Al-Hashr, كَيْ لَا يَكُونَ دُولَةً بَيْنَ الْأَغْنِيَاءِ مِنْكُمْ. The wealth must not be circulated by the wealthiest of you. The wealth must be fairly distributed. Yes, people have their own ownership, and this is recognized by the natural deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also regulates the relationship between the wealthy and the poor, between those who have the capital and those who work for them. And this is mentioned in the Quran. You can go back and look at that in many verses in the Quran and in the Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam within the system of zakah. That is the opposite of the system of riba. Back to Qarun. Inna Qarun kana min qawmi Musa fabagha alayhim. Wa atainahu min al kunuzi. Ma inna mafatihahu latanu'u bil usbati ulil quwwa. And we gave him Kunuz. Kunuz is the word as a plural of kanz. Kanz can be translated as treasure or safe. And the kanz in Arabic is the wealth that is not needed. So when you have a lot of wealth and you don't need it, it becomes kanz. You keep it somewhere. Allah says, we gave him treasures or safes. Ma inna mafatihu, that their keys are too heavy for a group of strong men to carry. Imagine you have some rooms in your house and you keep the keys together. All these keys. Qarun had the keys of his safes. He had a group of strong men to carry them, and it was still heavy for them to carry. These are just the keys of the unwanted wealth. The wealth he kept aside. You can imagine that, how wealthy this man was. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ. Then his people came to him. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ. Do not rejoice. Do not rejoice with your wealth and then you become arrogant. Do not celebrate this wealth to that extent. Do not rely on the money you have, on the treasures you hide. لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين. Make sure that you behave according to what Allah wants from you. Don't make your wealth dictate what to do. لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين. Allah does not like those who rejoice excessively, who become so proud of what they have. And then they said to him, وَابْتَغِي فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ وَلَا تَبْغِي الْفَسَادَ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. They gave him certain advices. Good people from his community. And you can imagine that community was not very wealthy. And this man was extremely rich. And then some people from that community went to him. And they were advising him for his own sake, to save him from the wrath of Allah. They said to him, first, لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين. Do not become arrogant because of this. Because Allah does not like those who have this quality. وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. They seek with what Allah gave you the hereafter. He said, with what you have, make this means to reach the Dar al-Akhirah safely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forbid for us to enjoy this dunya. Then they said to him, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Do not forget your share in the dunya. In fact, we are obliged to make use of this dunya. We are obliged to work and to earn and to get married and to have families and children and to enjoy what Allah creates for us in this dunya. We have an obligation to do that, not just a permission. He said, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. And the well-known story when the people came to the house of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to find out about his life. And they were told about his night prayers and his fasting. فَكَأَنَّهُمْ تَقَالُّوهَا. The hadith said, they kind of belittled it. They said, oh, is that it? Then they said to each other, yes. He can do this little, in terms of like of worship. He can enjoy this life. The reason is because his sins are all forgiven. He's the messenger. He's going to go to Al-Jannah anyway. But for us, one of them said, وَلَكِنِّي أَصُومُ وَلَا أُفْطِرُ. I'm going to fast all days. And the other one said, but for me, I'm going to pray all night, no sleep. And the third one said, I'm not going to get married. When Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and he was told about that, he called him back. He said to them, Ama, I swear by Allah, I am the most pious. And I am the most pious of you. I am the one who fears Allah the most. وَلَكِنِّي أَصُومُ وَأُفْطِرُ. I fast and I do not fast. وَأَنَامُ وَأُصَلِّي. I pray and sleep. And I get married to women. This is my way of life. فَمَنْ رَغِبَ عَنْ سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. The one who desires another way of life is not one of me. Allah, when He created Adam, He said, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. I'm going to create a successor on land. To succeed whom? To succeed Allah Himself. To be Allah's representative on this earth. To look after it by the permission and by the order and the guidance from the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they said to him, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. Do good as Allah has done good to you. Now they are reminding him, what you have is not from you. It is from Allah who gave you what you have. Then in return, you have to give good to others. You have to use what Allah gave you according to what Allah wants from you. You are entrusted on this wealth. وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ لَيْكَ وَلَا تَبْغِي الْفَسَادَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Do not desire transgression on land. And subhanAllah, I said earlier, that Qarun has become a system now. The system that spreads corruption everywhere. The system that enslaves people, denying their rights day and night. The system that makes legislations to protect those of wealth and oppress the poor even more and more. That was the system that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, in Qarun. That Qarun represented that system that exists today, but actually this system now is everywhere. The tyrants of today, who are the successors of Qarun, have created this kind of regulations, this system that very few people manage to escape from. SubhanAllah, Allah creates people free and no one has the right to enslave them. He said to him, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ وَلَا تَبْغِي الْفَسَادَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Do not desire to spread corruption on land. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. Allah does not like those who spread corruption, those who cause mischief. So they said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ and إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. Allah does not like those who rejoice arrogantly, and Allah does not like those who spread mischief. The reply of Qarun was very interesting. He said, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. I'm only given this because of my knowledge. He's like saying to them, what does your Lord have to do with my wealth? Why do I have to be good to others while I was given this because of my own knowledge? I work day and night. I'm so clever. I'm a very good businessman. I had my business plans and I studied, I had courses, did all of that. So because of that, I'm wealthy. Because of that, I was promoted and I become this rich person. It's not because of anyone else. And unfortunately, many of us do say that. If it's not by their tongues literally like this, but we do feel it sometimes. It is me. I'm a hard-working person. I've been making this business for 20 or 30 years. Now, here I am. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. It's because of my knowledge. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies to this lie. أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَهْلَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مَنْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُ قُوَّةً وَأَكْثَرُ جَمْعًا. Does not he know? Because he said, I'm giving it because of my knowledge. Allah said, while you were studying to do this, did not come across something that told you that Allah destroyed generations before you who were wealthier than you and who accumulated more than what you have? أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ Does not he know that? أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَهْلَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مَنْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُ قُوَّةً وَأَكْثَرُ جَمْعًا وَلَا يُسْأَلُ عَنْ ذُنُوبِهِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ The criminals are not even asked, are not even questioned about their sins. They are totally insignificant. They are worthless of even being questioned. Allah destroys them without giving them any chance. أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَهْلَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ Many generations lived this lavish way of life. They enjoyed the luxury even more than you. But then what happened to them? They left. Allah destroyed them. Either the wealth was taken away, or they were destroyed, or they naturally died and left all of that behind. أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَهْلَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مَنْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُ قُوَّةً وَأَكْثَرُ جَمْعًا وَلَا يُسْأَلُ عَنْ ذُنُوبِهِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ فَخَرَجَ عَلَى قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ Now he came out in front of his people with all the adornment, all the luxury, all the slaves, and can imagine, you can keep visualizing the way you like. Allah mentioned this brief in the Quran to leave it open for us to imagine it. فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ He came out in front of his people with all his zina, his adornment. Adornment of someone who had that much wealth that we spoke about. قَالَ الَّذِينَ يُرِيدُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا Those who desire the life of this dunya said, يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونَ We wish we had something similar to what Qarun has been given. إِنَّهُ لَذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ He's so lucky. We wish we had something like that. We wish we had this comfortable and enjoyable life. We wish we had a portion of this wealth. يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونَ Why they say that? Why we say that? Many times, because we have the wrong parameters in our hearts. We measure things with the materialistic value of this life. We don't look at the reality beyond what we see. We can only sense and comprehend what our eyes can see. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while He mentions this story in Surah Al-Qasas, is telling us to have our parameters right, to calibrate our hearts, to get the right measurements. So when you see something, don't only look at what you see, think about the value behind it. The value of الدار الآخرة, the value that the creator of this world is pleased with. قال الذين يريدون الحياة الدنيا يا ليت لنا مثل ما أوتي قارون إنه لذو حظ عظيم Today, with the social media, and the television and others, everyone, not talking about young people, even old people, everyone is so amazed with what we see. People of very expensive cars, people who have their own private flights, people who go out for very expensive holidays. We see sometimes people come here in London to spend thousands and thousands of pounds in nonsense. We see all of that. But most of the time when we see that, we think, these people are so lucky. These people have been given a lot. We wish we had a portion of that. When young people today talk about what the footballers earn, 20, 30, 50,000 a week. They say, wow, that's amazing. Imagine if I have even 1,000 a week. My life would be totally different. I would do a lot of good things. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Qasas, قَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَإِلَكُمْ. And those who were given knowledge, and again remember the word knowledge, because Qarun said, I was given this because of my knowledge. Fake knowledge. And Allah said, does not he know that we destroyed generations before him? He didn't have the real knowledge. And then Allah said here, and those who were given the knowledge, but this is the true knowledge of the physical world and the metaphysical world, was beyond our senses. Those who understand the real values of what we see in this life, they said, وَإِلَّكُمْ Woe to you, what is wrong with you? They were talking to their own people who were really astonished by what they saw. وَإِلَكُمْ ثَوَابُ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ The reward of Allah is better. What are you talking about? How can you be so amazed by this? This has no value. This is just fake. This is an illusion of this dunya. وَإِلَكُمْ ثَوَابُ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِمَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا The reward of Allah is better for the one who believed and worked righteously. وَلَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الصَّابِرُونَ And only the patient ones are given this. Given that understanding. Those who are patient to face the fake values of most of people. The fake understanding, the illusion of the world around us. Those who are patient to face that are the ones who are given this understanding. Those who are patient because of the hardship of this dunya. Those who are patient from going to these directions. Of those who have wealth and they are just interested in getting more wealth. Regardless of how they get it or how they spend it. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that everyone's feet will not be removed on the day of judgment. Meaning that you cannot leave before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. Everyone's feet are not going to be removed يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع until he is questioned about four. And one of them he said, وعن ماله من أين اكتسبه وفيما انفقه and about his wealth. Where did he get it from? And how he spent it. It's not just about getting the money, it's about spending the money. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us certain and strict regulations. You must get your wealth only in these ways. You must not get your wealth in these certain ways. And when you spend it, you must spend it in these lawful channels. No other than them. When you have your wealth, when Allah gives you something, then you must do certain things with this, with what you have. وَلَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الصَّابِرُونَ Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed those people all the parties of that story. Now you can think there are different groups. Qarun and those who were with him. Because when you have a tyrant like that, normally there are some other people around him who benefit from this tyranny. So you'll find the CEO and business manager and account manager and facility manager. You have these people around him, they benefit from this. And you have a group of people who were trying to advise him to change. And you have also a group of people who were really astonished by that wealth and they wanted to have something similar. And you have another group of people who are telling them, this actually is not true, this is not real. We should not look at it like this. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, showed them all His sign. An ayah, a miracle. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ Allah ordered the earth to swallow him. And his palace. It was swallowed by the earth in front of everyone. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ فما كان له من فئة ينصرونه من دون الله وما كان من المنتصرين. He had no group to protect him from Allah, and he was not helped. Where is the wealth? Where is the power? Where are the servants? Where is the knowledge? Where is the money? The equipment? All of that was swallowed by the earth. All of that disappeared in front of other people. And Allah is telling us this story in order to learn from it. Maybe in our lives we don't see this, but Allah is telling us that the fate of those who spread mischief, the fate of those who are oppressors and tyrants, is going to be similar, sooner or later. And Allah said, وَأَصْبَحَ الَّذِينَ تَمَنَّوا مَكَانَهُ بِالْأَمْسِ. And those who wished his place, those who wished to be in his place before, after seeing this, they said, يَقُولُونَ وَيْكَأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَقْدِرُ. They said, it is Allah who stretches his provision to whom he likes from his servants, and he tightens it. When Allah gives a lot in this life, is not a sign of acceptance, and is not also a sign of rejection. Allah gives according to his own will. Something has no law in this life. We don't understand it. Why Allah gives this person and deprives the other, we don't know. It is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَقْدِرُ لَوْلَا أَمَّنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا لَقَسَفَ بِنَا. They said, Alhamdulillah. We were not given something similar to Qarun, because we know ourselves, if we were given this, we would do the same, and we would end up in the same place. لَوْلَا أَمَّنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا لَقَسَفَ بِنَا. If Allah gave us something similar, we would have been swallowed by the earth. In the same way. وَيْكَأَنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Those who are ungrateful never succeed. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ خَيْرٌ مِّنْهَا وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ فَلَا يُجْزَى الَّذِينَ عَمِلُوا السَّيِّئَاتِ إِلَّا مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Subhanallah, it's like a conclusion at the end. He said, what's the lesson you get from this? Allah says, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ. That is the life of the hereafter. نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا ي... Make it your aim. And that one is only for those who do not desire to be arrogant and do not desire to spread mischief in that. نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the end is always for the pious ones. The end in this dunya and al-akhirah. Qarun disappeared, and then those people remained after him. Fir'aun drowned, and this Musa remained after him. Every tyrant goes. And العاقبة للمتقين ولقد سبقت كلمتنا لعبادنا المرسلين إنهم لهم المنصورون وإن جندنا لهم الغالبون. All the time, the truth is what remains, and the falsehood goes, vanishes, because it has no base, has no foundation. والعاقبة للمتقين. What happens there in the hereafter? Allah says, من جاء بالحسنة فله خير منها. The one who goes there with good deeds will get more, will get better than them. Not what Qarun had. In al-Jannah. Not in this life. Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my brothers and sisters, said about this life, لو كانت الدنيا تساوي عند الله جناح بعوضة ما سقى منها كافرا شربة ماء. If this dunya is equivalent to a wing of a mosquito, Allah wouldn't have given a sip of water to a disbeliever. This dunya altogether is not even equivalent to a wing of a mosquito. Allah says in al-akhirah, من جاء بالحسنة فله خير منها. You get better than what you do. ومن جاء بالسيئة, but the one who comes with a sin is going to be only punished according to his sin. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us away from the path of tyranny and arrogance. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this dunya in our hands but not in our hearts. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time to fill our hearts of the love of al-akhirah and al-jannah, and to help us in this dunya to follow the footsteps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to stay away, far away from the path of the criminals and those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك ومن النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم اغننا بحلالك عن حرامك, وبطاعتك عن معصيتك, وبفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك. أعنا على تلاوته وتدبره والعمل به على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا, برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم, وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين, وأقم الصلاة.